after long and fruitless waiting, I have determined to write to you myself, as much for your sake as for mine, as I would not like to think that I had passed through 2 long years of imprisonment without ever having received a single line from you, or any news or message even, except such as gave me pain.
Wilde wrote only one thing whilst incarcerated in Reading Jail, and that was a letter that became known as De Profundis.
It feels haunted. You just can sense the human lives. And it's a very poetic space because there are lots of little traces left of people and their stories, but only fragments.
There's something of De Profundis and the feelings of sorrow, of pain, of remorse, of self-awareness, of self-revelation. Each of the works somehow, and the letters, the sculpture installations, speak to in some way. So De Profundis is a kind of anchor.
If you find one false excuse for yourself, you will soon find 100. And be just what you were before. Do you still say, as you said to Robbie in your answer, that I attribute unworthy motives to you? Ah, you had no motives in life. You had appetites merely. A motive is an intellectual aim.
I think there's something about De Profundis where you feel the immediacy of the pen on the paper. Feel it in the writing. It's just another kind of spirit which is not the considered, the considered turn of phrase. I mean, he has innately a beautiful sense of language, so that's in De Profundis. But you feel the pain and the need, the immediacy of the need to express flows through De Profundis, I think. It's alarming because it feels so present.
First time I've been inside a prison, and it's probably true for many of us, and it made me think about how, as a society, we participate in mass incarceration all over the world, and yet most people don't have any idea what that's like. It's something that is part of our kind of consciousness, I suppose, in daily life, and yet we never experience it or never experience it physically, so being here was a real revelation.
I have had here to look at my past face to face. Well, look at your past face to face. Sit down quietly and consider it. The supreme vice is shallowness. Whatever is realized is right.
Young Architect of the Year, the winner.